How are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine. Welcome back to English class. In our today's English class, we are going to study Chapter 2 of Literature. Chapter 2, A Tasty Feast for the Mice. Now, what is the meaning of this title? Title says, A Tasty means yummy, delicious. Feast means meal. For whom? For the mice. Mice is plural form of mouse. Okay. So, the tasty feast for the mice. What is there in the story? In this story, there are some boys, group of boys who are traveling to their, who are traveling in the train. They are going to their boarding school. Okay. These boys studied in a boarding school, means in a hostel, and they are returning to their boarding school after their summer vacation. But they are very upset. Why they are upset? They are upset because their favorite Sanskrit teacher has retired and a new teacher has been appointed in its place. Okay, new teacher ko rakha gaya hai. और उनके फेवरेट टीचर है वो रिटायर हो चुके हैं, तो ये उनकी सैडनेस का रीजन है. अब वो लोग जब बैठे होते हैं ट्रेन में अपने कंपार्टमेंट में, तब एक ओल्ड जेंटलमैन वहां एंटर करता है. ओके, अ ओल्ड जेंटलमैन एंटर्स देयर कंपार्टमेंट एंड दे बिकम लिटिल बिट सीरियस. देन दे ट्राई ऑल पॉसिबल वेज to get rid of this old gentleman. Okay, they harass him. And this old gentleman is none other than the new teacher. But he keeps it as a secret. And he tries to win the hearts of these boys. This is a very beautiful story. And we are going to study this now from the book.
We will study this chapter in detail. In earlier times, boys from neighboring towns and villages of Kolkata would often come to the city for their education. Means the boys from nearby towns and villages would come to Kolkata for their studies. Kolkata had good boarding schools then. At that time, Kolkata were having many good boarding schools. The boys would stay in the school hostel for 10 months and then go back home to spend the 2 months of their long summer holidays with their family. The boys would stay in the school, okay, to study for 10 months, and after their academic year is over, okay, after 10 months, they would go to spend the summer vacation with their families. They used to go to their homes. Second paragraph, holidays over. The boys from one of these boarding schools were returning to Kolkata. Holidays got over. The boys from one of these boarding schools, means a group of boys, were returning to their school. The train was crowded. The train was so much crowded, there was no place. Okay, but these boys captured a full compartment. Means these boys had taken a full compartment and managed to sit in that compartment, okay, for themselves. They were going back to school feeling a little sad. They were feeling sad. Their favorite old Sanskrit teacher had retired because their favorite old teacher had retired and a new teacher, Kali Kumar, had been appointed. So the old teacher is retired and school is appointing a new teacher. So they were disappointed. Okay, they were sad because they don't want new teacher. They liked their teacher so. The boys were not happy with this news. We don't want a new teacher. We don't want a new teacher. They sang out in chorus. Sang out in chorus means to speak, to sing in. A chorus means to sing together. Okay, we don't want a new teacher. Finally, they resorted to grumbling and making fun of the new teacher. Finally, when they can't do anything, they were unable to do anything, they started complaining and they started complaining in a very bad manner because they were feeling annoyed and making fun of the new teacher. Okay, they started resorting and grumbling and making fun of the new teacher. Someone composed a parody of his name and changed it from Kali Kumar Tarkalankar to Kalo Kumro Tatkalanka. From that boys, one of the boys started making fun of the teacher and composed a parody. Parody means a humorous, funny lines to tease someone. Okay. To create something funny line, to create a funny line to tease anyone, to abuse anyone. He changed it from Kali Kumar Tatkalankar to Kalo Kumro Tatkalanka, which means black pumpkin and fresh green chilies, which means black pumpkin and fresh green chili, which are generally being avoided. Okay. The other boys joined in and began making fun. Okay, others also joined and began making funny but humiliating punchlines. Humiliating means insulting, okay, abusing. So they also joined and made such punchlines, such lines they sang out about the new teacher. They laughed at the thought of black pumpkin and green chili. Pumpkin is a vegetable, kaddu, okay. We call it kaddu. Black pumpkin and green chili being chopped and sacrificed at the meal times. Means they are chopped but they are not used. Okay, no one wants it. So, they laughed at the thought of the same. They made up their mind to get rid of this new teacher soon. They made up their mind. They decided that we will do something so that the teacher goes away. Okay, teacher will not stay with us. Teacher will leave. The train stopped at Arkola, a small station. Train stops at Arkola station. And an elderly gentleman boarded the boys' compartment. Elderly means an old gentleman boarded the train and came to boys' compartment. He had a lot of luggage. Okay, he had lot of carriage. He had lot of bags and things with him. He had luggage with him, a bedroll, a large case, some cloth bundles and earthen pots full of eatables. So many things he had with him. A bedroll, okay, which he can spread and can sit or relax. A large case means a large, we can say suitcase, and some cloth bundles and earthen pots full of eatables, means having some things which are eatable like sweets. The boys obviously did not want an elderly traveling companion to spoil their fun. The boys did not want any old man to accompany them, to spoil their fun. They were making fun, right? They were enjoying, so they didn't want that old man to accompany them, to be in their compartment. So they rudely told him right away. So they very rudely told them, directly told them, there is no place for you to sit here. Okay, यहाँ पे जगह नहीं है. There is no place for you to sit here. Please look up some other compartment. There is no place. You go somewhere else and please look at some other compartment. The gentleman replied calmly, the entire train is very crowded. The gentleman replied that there is no space anywhere and the train is fully crowded. There is no space anywhere and there is no place where I can adjust. यहाँ पर एकदम भीड़ है, जगह कहीं पे भी जगह मिले वैसा है नहीं. Don't worry, I won't disturb you, nor I will take up much space. I'll manage somehow. Don't worry, I won't disturb you. I won't disturb you or involve you with. I will not disturb you. I will not harass you. So don't get worried. I won't take much space. I will adjust in little space, and I'll manage somehow. Before the boys could react, he spread his bedroll on the floor and settled down comfortably. Before the boys could react, they could say anything, the old man spread his bedroll, yani chattai hum bol sakte hain, he spread his bedroll and settled down. Wo wahan par niche baith gaye comfortably. The boys could not bring themselves up to make someone a butt of their rude jokes before a complete stranger. Now the boys could not make their mischief. They can't make their rude jokes in front of a complete stranger. Okay, they can't have fun or they can't say anything before this old man. Silence lingered for some time in the compartment. Everyone became silent. No one was speaking. Okay, so the gentleman asked, where are you all headed to? Where are all of you headed to? Where are you going? He asked. The boys told him about their boarding school in Kolkata. The boys replied that we are going to our boarding school, which is in Kolkata. But why do you look so glum? The man inquired. The man asked why you are looking so sad or why you are looking so quiet and you are not saying anything. The boys replied sadly, we are unhappy with the news that our new Sanskrit teacher is replacing our old one this session. We are unhappy, we are sad with the news that a new teacher is replacing our old Sanskrit teacher, and the teacher was our favorite teacher. We plan to irritate him so much that he is forced to leave promptly. We will harass him, we will irritate him, we will annoy him. So he will leave the job. Okay, so he is forced to leave. At the next stop, which is Asansol, the old man briefly alighted to have a drink of water. The old man came down of the train, okay, and descended the train to drink water. On his return, he found his bundles missing. When he came back after having water, he saw that his bundles were missing and the mouths of his earthen pots were open. The earthen pots in which sweets were there were open, okay. The rasogullas, laddus and gulab jamuns packed tight in the pots were all gone. There were no sweets left. Okay. Rasgulla, laddus and gulab jamuns were not there. Okay. Means the earthen pots were empty. Even the mangoes that were secured tight in cloth bundle had disappeared. He had also brought mangoes, okay, which he had kept in a cloth bundle. that were also disappeared, vanished. The mischievous boys who had helped themselves to a good meal explained. These boys were very mischievous, okay, naughty. So they had all eaten it. So they explained, there are lots of mice on the train and they made a feast of your sweets and fruits. They explained that they have not eaten. They wanted to say that these things are not eaten by us. There are lots of mice on the train and they made a feast of your sweets. The mice had a good great meal of your sweets and fruits. What a pity, the man said calmly. The man expressed the sadness. What a pity, the man said calmly. If I had known that there were mice on this train, I would have carried an extra box of snacks for them and also for you. He calmly said, if I was knowing that there will be mice on this train, I would have carried an extra box. Okay, I would have carried more snacks and more fruits and more sweets for the mice and also for you, for both of them. The boys were taken aback and disappointed that their plan to trouble this man hadn't worked. The boys were disappointed because this was their plan, that we will eat everything and we will harass this man. But the man was chilled, okay, the man was still in a calm state of mind. And he said that if I would have known that I would bring more. So, their plan didn't work. To their dismay, neither was the man angry, nor did he leave the compartment. They were amazed, they were shocked that the man was not angry, was not irritated, or the man did not leave the compartment also. The train finally stopped at Bardhaman station. Here they all changed trains for Kolkata. Previously, there was no direct train. The passengers used to change two or three trains to reach the final destination. So here the train stopped at Bardhaman station and they changed the trains for Kolkata. When the boys settled down in a compartment, the old gentleman said, I'll find my way to some other compartment. The old man said that this time I will go elsewhere. I will not harass you, or I will not interrupt in your privacy, and I will find my way to other compartment. The boys were ridden with guilt and wanted to make up for their mischief. The boys were feeling guilty, okay? They were feeling very sorry and they were feeling very guilty from inside. So they wanted to make up for their mischief. They wanted to improve that mistake, okay? They wanted to say sorry or to behave nicely with the gentleman. So they insisted that he sat with them. The boys were ridden with guilt and wanted to make up for their mischief. So they insisted that he sat with them. They insisted ke nahi aap nahi idhar hi aap baitho. Okay, you stay with us only. They forced him. They told him again and again to accompany them. The train chugged off and soon reached the next station. Okay, the train chugged off means the train steamed away. The train started started running and reached the next station. The old man bought a big packet of sweets from a hawker. The old gentleman brought a big packet of sweets from a hawker. Hawker means vendor, feria. Okay, we can say they are roaming and wandering in the stations, even they come in the train, right? So they were roaming and the old gentleman purchased a big packet of sweets on the platform for the boys. They happily gobbled them means to eat quickly and hungrily. So they gobbled them down. Again at the next station, the gentleman bought a dozen ripe mangoes. Again, next station comes. At that station also, the old man purchases a dozen of ripe mangoes for the boys. By now, they had begun to grow fond of their friendly and cheerful old man. By now, they were very happy with the old man. Okay, they were liking this old man now. And they were liking that how friendly and cheerful this old man is. So he had played a very good game. He bought goodies at every station and the boys finished them gladly. Finally, they asked him, "Sir, where are you going?" The boys asked the old man, "Where was he going?" "I am in the search of job and will settle down wherever I find one," he replied. The old man replies that he is in search of job. He wants a job and he is looking for it. He will settle down wherever he will get a job. "And what is your profession? What do you do?" Okay, the boys are asking the old man, "What is your profession or in which field you are?" "I am a teacher," replied the old man. The old man says that "I am a teacher." On further questioning, the boys learnt that he taught Sanskrit. The boys must have asked that which subjects you teach, what you teach. The old man is teaching Sanskrit. So the old man says that "I teach Sanskrit." They asked excitedly. Now they became excited. Okay, because the new teacher has retired and some unknown teacher is going to come, which they didn't like. So they asked that, "Why don't you apply for a job in our school?" They were very excited because they liked this old man and they had become fond of this old man. So they asked, "Why don't you apply? Why don't you try for a job in our school? Our Sanskrit teacher has retired. And the secretary of the school committee is planning to appoint a new one." Means they tell the old man that the Sanskrit teacher has retired. So there is a place, there is a vacancy. So why don't you apply here? "Don't worry, sir. We'll take care of that." "Sir, why don't you apply for a job in our school? Our Sanskrit teacher has retired and the secretary of school committee is planning to appoint a new one." Means the committee, school committee wants a new candidate. "So why don't you apply in our school?" "But if the secretary doesn't like me or my way of teaching, he will not give me the job," the gentleman said gravely. "But if the secretary or the committee members doesn't like me or the way of my teaching, then they will not appoint me. They will not give me a job," the gentleman said seriously. Don't worry, sir. We will take care of that. We will not cooperate with the new teacher at all, so that he is forced to leave, making way for you. If they don't appoint you, we will protest. Don't worry, sir. We'll take care of that. We will take care that you are selected or you are appointed. We will not cooperate with the new teacher. We will not obey the new teacher and we will not cooperate with the new teacher. So the new teacher will be annoyed. Okay, we will harass the new teacher. So the new teacher will be annoyed and she will leave forcefully. Okay, she will or he will leave the job. The new teacher will not continue the job, making way for you. So that we will make the way for you to come. If they don't appoint you, if they are not appointing you, the whosoever the new teacher will come, we will not cooperate, we will not obey, we will not follow the new teacher. So again, there will be a way for you. And if they don't appoint, we will protest. We will protest means we will protest matlab virodh karna. Okay, we will protest and leave the school. We will protest means to fight, means to disagree. We will disagree and leave the school, the boys said in chorus. Excited at this new development. This new development means this new things which they were planning out. They were very excited now. They began chanting the humiliating rhyme about Kali Kumar Tarkar Lankar. They had composed the rhyme, the funny lines, and they started reciting it again in chorus. Kali Kumar Tarka Lankar, referring him as black pumpkin and fresh green chilies. They were making fun of Kali Kumar Tarka Lankar. All right, take me to your school. I'll try once, agreed the gentleman. Finally, the gentleman, the old man, agrees. Okay, he says, all right, I'll come with you. Take me to your school and I apply once, I'll try once. The train reached Kolkata and the boys were surprised to see the secretary of the school committee. The old man agrees to go with them and apply once and try once. The train reached the final destination, Kolkata. And the boys were surprised because they saw secretary of the school committee waiting on the platform. They saw that the secretary was standing. They wondered if he had come to welcome them. They were surprised and shocked because they thought that why did the secretary had come. They wondered if he had come to welcome them. They thought that they were wondered because they thought that the secretary had come to receive them, had come to welcome them. Finally, they found him walking towards the old gentleman from the train. They saw that the secretary was walking towards the old gentleman from the train. The secretary touched the gentleman's feet and said, Welcome, Tarka Lankar sir. We have made all arrangements for you in the school. They saw that the gentleman was coming towards the old man. The secretary touched the gentleman's feet. The secretary touched the feet of the old man who was accompanying this boys in the compartment. The secretary said, Welcome. Secretary welcomed. Tarka Lankar sir, we have made all arrangements for you in the school. We have made all the arrangements so that you can teach and you can stay at the school. The boys looked at each other, utterly bewildered. The boys looked at each other and they were really confused and puzzled, realizing their folly. They were confused, realizing their mistake. The old man from the train had played the trump card. The old man from the train had played the game, had played the trump card, had won the trump card. Trump card is the card which comes, which defines the winning. Okay. When you get the trump card, that means you will win that game. So the old man had won the game and it was actually their new Sanskrit teacher who had been traveling with them all this while. The boys looked at each other confused and puzzled and they realized that it was their mistake. ठीक है, बॉयज एक दूसरे के सामने देखते हैं और वो थोड़े कंफ्यूज्ड है और उसके बाद उनको अपनी भूल, अपनी मिस्टेक रियलाइज होती है. द ओल्ड मैन फ्रॉम द ट्रेन हैड प्लेड द ट्रम्प कार्ड. द ओल्ड मैन हु वॉज ट्रैवलिंग विद देम, ओके, फ्रॉम द स्टेशंस हैड प्लेड द ट्रम्प गेम. इसका मतलब कि जो ओल्ड मैन उनके साथ उनके कंपार्टमेंट में ट्रैवल कर रहा था वही ओल्ड मैन उनका टीचर है, उनके न्यू टीचर है. सो दैट मैन हैड प्लेड द ट्रम्प कार्ड, क्योंकि ओल्ड मैन ने उनको बताया नहीं कि जिनका आप मजाक उड़ा रहे हो, जिनको आप परेशान कर रहे हो, वो और कोई नहीं पर मैं ही हूँ. जिनके बारे में आप प्लानिंग कर रहे हो, जिनके बारे में जिनका मजाक उड़ा रहे हो आप, ठीक है, यू आर सिंगिंग द पैरडी, तो वो और कोई नहीं, मैं ही हूँ. आई एम ओनली कली कुमार. ही डिड नॉट इंट्रोड्यूस हिमसेल्फ बिफोर एंड वॉन द हार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉयज. ओके, उन सबका दिल जीत लिया, उन सबको मज़े करवाए. उनको बताया नहीं कि मैं तरका लंकर सर हूँ, आपका न्यू टीचर मैं ही हूँ, ऐसा नहीं बताया. मीन्स ही हैड प्लेड द ट्रम्प कार्ड. इट वॉज एक्चुअली द न्यूली अपॉइंटेड संस्कृत टीचर हु हैड बीन ट्रैवलिंग विद देम ऑल दिस वाइल. वॉजंट दिस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग? यस, दिस वॉज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. द एंडिंग वॉज वेरी मिस्टीरियस. And hope you have enjoyed this chapter.
Okay, students, I hope you understood this. Now you have to read.